now our distinguished House members, Carolyn Maloney, Larry Kudlow's congresswoman. She's a Democrat from New York and the former chair of the Joint Economic Committee. How about that? And the committee's current vice chair, Kevin Brady, Republican from Texas. Carolyn Maloney, let me just go to you. Bernanke outlines, you know, it's not a good economy. He's worried about employment and unemployment. He's worried about Europe. He's worried about fiscal cliffs. He's worried about everything, but he didn't pull the QE3 trigger. Carolyn Maloney, do you think he should have pulled the QE3 trigger?
Well, I don't think he wanted commitments before the June 19th federal board meeting, so he didn't come out strongly in any direction. He just kept all options on the table. But many of the people around him did pull the trigger for any stimulus that's needed or any support for a fragile economy. Janet Yellen, the vice chairman of the Fed, most economists, Dandy to Nobel laureate Krugman, have all called for more involvement, particularly when you see the crisis in Europe and now the downturn in China. 2% growth looks good, and I think he's done a good job, Mr. Bernanke, and I hope he'll do everything he can to keep this economy moving and to support a fragile economy given the world situation.
All right, Kevin Brady, I pose the same question to you. As Carolyn put it, you've got a shaky world economy, you got fiscal cliff, you got anemic recovery here at home. Is it Ben Bernanke's purview? Should he ease?
No, he shouldn't. In fact, QE1, QE2 didn't work to boost the economy or create jobs. It gave a sugar high to the stock market. That's not what we need. It creates more, I think, uncertainty within the market. And again, I think the real problem is that we're facing this fiscal cliff. The Congress has not got its financial house in order. The president continues to talk about higher taxes on job creators, and now we've seen just this tsunami of red tape on businesses as well as this health care plan. You know, I think there are limits to what monetary policy can do, and we've reached them.
Carolyn Maloney, have we reached those limits? And let me just pose this. I want to set this up. We've had roughly $1 trillion of federal government spending, but with the Fed, they've created roughly $2.5 trillion of new money. And what we got out of that is really the worst recovery since the end of World War II. What happened? Why didn't this work? You understand the economy. You were on the Joint Economic Committee for years. All this Fed stimulus, it didn't work. What happened?
Well, first, Larry, let's put it in perspective. When President Obama walked in the door, this economy was shedding 750,000 jobs a month. We've now had, because of his fiscal policy, 27 months of job growth, creating 4.3 million jobs. That record is 60% better than George W. Bush's record in 7.5 years.
Well, Larry, if I could, not to interrupt Carolyn, but I'd like to point out that unemployment rates averaged 5.5% under President Bush. I wish we had that same type of a record under President Obama. Dead last
in modern history, economies is
not a good record to be running on.
Well, I tell you, the Republican record of supporting the old European policies of austerity and growing unemployment, they're at 11%. If we keep following them, we might get to 11% unemployment.
Well, we need a balanced approach.
That's what the president's calling for, and that's what actually Chairman Bernanke called for, balanced approach.
Let me come back to everything on the table
and solve this.
All right, let me come back to monetary policy just a second. Let me come back to the Fed. Kevin Brady, you don't want Fed to come in, and I read, actually I watched on YouTube some of your remarks at the hearing today, and you're worried about inflation, and you don't want the Fed to pour more money into a potential inflation. But I want to ask you this, I'll pose it to both of you. If you look at some of these market price indicators, okay, the dollar is soaring, commodity prices are falling, oil is falling, that's probably a good thing, but it's another deflating commodity. The CRB commodity index is deflating. Are you at all worried, Kevin Brady, that there may be a greater risk of deflation right now in the USA and the world economy than inflation?
You know, that always is that concern. And as you know, deflation is so tough to battle. One of my big worries, again, about shoving all this money in the economy is it planted the seeds for inflation. You don't see it until it's in the pipeline, and it will occur so quickly the Fed won't have the chance to exit appropriately and in time. And again, back to the uncertainty, I really think job creators back home are not waiting to hire people because of what the Fed will do. They're not hiring because what a government will do to them, higher taxes, not handling their financial situation, the regulatory flood that they're experiencing today.
You know, Ms. Maloney, as a supply-sider, I would prefer to lower marginal tax rates. You know that, and probably bored to tears, so I'm not going to take you down that road again. Mm-hmm. But I will say this. As a longtime watcher of the Fed, and I used to practice economics for a living, if the problem is deflation, Carolyn, the solution is, in fact, to print more money. I'm going to give you the last word. What do you think?
Well, Chairman Bernanke testified today that he did not think that deflation was a problem at this point. He said that we needed a balanced approach, that we had to address this with a balanced approach that implied not only austerity and cutting back, but also revenues and investments in our infrastructure. Why in the world can't we get a transportation bill? That used to be like apple pie. Let's put Americans to work and repair the $2 trillion damage that is reported in our House. The House has sent over
30 jobs bills to the Senate. The Senate's sitting on 30 separate jobs bill to get the economy going. That's what we ought to be doing.
Okay, and the president has sent over his transportation bill, his jobs bill, his balanced approach that would have tax breaks for everybody except for zillionaires and billionaires.
And the Senate hasn't passed one.
Both of you, you're great. I'm sorry, I've just got to move on. We've got one more segment to do. I would just suggest to you, be careful about deflation because it creeps up on you. House members, Carolyn Maloney and Kevin Brady, thank you both ever so much.
Good to see you, Larry.
All right, up next.
Good to see my neighbor.
All right, up next, okay, Ben Bernanke.